Hi students, how are you all? I am your social science teacher. I teach history, geography. I am Miss Logan Ayagi. You all remember me? Yes. Last year I was your class teacher. This year I am going to be your social science teacher. I'll teach history and geography. By the way, how are you all? Staying at home, listening videos, doing assignments? Well done. Very good. Okay, we'll continue to learn this year history, geography, isn't it? Yes. Okay. For the first lesson, we'll learn in history Harappan civilization. Okay, this is a lesson you learnt in 6th standard. Again, you are going to learn one more time elaborately. Okay, the lesson name is Harappan civilization. Okay. Before that, you should know where is this Harappan civilization? Were there in the past? Okay. This is Harappa. This is Mohenjo-Daro. These are the two places we are going to learn. It's in part of Pakistan, in part of India. These are the some sites, some of the cities. The dot of red, this square of red is the main center, that is Mohenjo-Daro and Harappa. Okay, we are going to make this map, okay, like this in your India map. This way you are going to make one map. This is your assignment. You have to make this map. Okay, this is the five rivers and this is the Indus River, and here only Harappa you find, Harappa, and here Mohenjo-Daro. Okay, it's part of Pakistan, it's part of India. Can you see this? Yes, like this you can do this a map of Harappan civilization. This all yellow part is Harappan civilization. Okay, can you see this map? Yes, this may be in your book. Okay, no need to draw all cities or sites. Okay, just you do this Pakistan, Mohenjo-Daro, Harappa, India, the important one. Okay, yes. Okay. The first and the best example of Indus Valley civilization found at Harappa. This civilization sometimes called the Harappan civilization because we found many of the sites in Harappan civilization. Okay, that's why we are calling this Harappan civilization. The one more name was Indus Valley civilization. Indus Valley civilization we call Harappan civilization. In 6th standard you learnt as Indus Valley civilization because it's nearby Indus River. Can you see Indus River? Yes. Because of that we call in Indus Valley civilization. In basically we call Indus Valley civilization. All civilization started near with rivers. That's why we call Indus Valley civilization. River Indus Valley. But why now in 9th standard we are putting the name Harappan civilization? Because we are going to learn as depth. Many of the things we are found from the Harappa. This is the place, main site, Harappa. From this place, we found many things. That's why we are calling this Harappan civilization. Same name, Indus Valley civilization and Harappan civilization, same only. But the name, why we are changing and calling that? Because many of the excavation found, maybe the archaeologists found many of the things from Harappan civilization. Okay, that's why we are calling this Harappan civilization. You understood that? Yes. Now we come to know the Harappan civilization. The ruins of the city were discovered at the distance of 160 kilometers from Lahore on the Ravi River. Okay, it was probably the capital of the northern region. It was well planned city like Mohenjo-Daro. It was bigger in area and Mohenjo-Daro. It was first city of Indus Valley to be excavated in 1921. That's why we are calling this the Harappan civilization. Okay, you understand? This is the place only they found first in 1921. Okay, by the way, the year was the Harappan civilization, people were lived in the BC 3000 year BC, from there to 1500 BC. Okay, that is before Christ, we call BC, or before common era. Okay, BC 3000 BC, from there to 1500 BC, you have to decrease. Okay, now we are increasing 2019 2020 2021, like that we are increasing and going. I mean, the those days before Jesus Christ born, the years were decreasing. Okay, so 3000 BC to 2500 or 700, they are telling approximately, but the period 3250 BC to 2750 BC. Okay, so we can tell 3000 to 1500, but accurately they are telling this 3250 BC to 2750 BC. BC means before Jesus Christ birth, or before common era, nowadays we are calling this. Okay, this is the period of the Harappan people lived there. Okay, that time they lived, but they excavated in 1921 they excavated. Okay, the excavation means digging the place and finding the taking the ruins, the destroyed one, broken one, from there. This is the place. Okay, now we understand little bit of our Harappan civilization. Suddenly, why we are calling Harappan civilization, not we are not calling Indus Valley civilization? You understood that? Yes, because many of the places around the Harappa, so that's why we are calling that Harappan civilization. Many of the excavation done in nearby Harappa. Okay, same, we can use this word also, Indus Valley civilization and Harappan civilization, both are same civilization. Okay, in the year 1921 they started to excavate. Okay, but people lived there 3000 BC, from 3000 BC to 1500 BC or 2750, accurately if we say this is the year 3250 BC to 2750 BC. Okay, you understand that much? Yes, now we learn about the town planning. This is the thing you are going to learn. Okay, the Great Bath, Citadel, Seals, Beard Man, Dancing Girl, Dockyard Script, and Urban Planning. These are the things we are going to learn in this lesson. Okay, this is the town planning of Harappan civilization. Harappan people lived here. This is a town. The west part is we call Citadel, the east part we call Lower Town. Okay, then in the Citadel we see the, this is the town plan, we call the Citadel. Citadel was raised platform, rectangular in shape and about 12 meters high. In this only we find this. Okay, it was constructed with the bricks and stones with watchtowers. Okay, now we cannot see anything clearly, but they found by the excavation. Okay, it has the constructed with the bricks and stones with watchtowers. It had massive walls and height acted to protection of the against the floods. Now we can see just a ground. Those time it was built by, like that people excavated and they found and they were written this. It is believed that the ruler along with the nobles lived here. Okay, in the place Citadel, people with the ruling party, they live here. The important public buildings like granaries, Great Bath. See, this is the Great Bath. This is the granary. Everything situated in the Citadel. Okay, that is the higher part of the town. okay, the lower part is the people who are residential buildings where common people live there. Okay, the common people live in the lower part of this town. Okay, the higher part of the town is people who are ruling. The lower part of the town, people who are the common people, farmers, artisans, normal people live there. This is the town plan. This is the street. Okay, can you see the streets in Mohenjo-daro? Yes, the street of Mohenjo-daro varied from 3 meters to 4 meters. Okay, the roads were 4 meters to 10 meters. All the streets and roads ran from the north to south, from east to west, so that it could be cleaned automatically by the wind. If wind flows this way, automatically the wind will clean the road and go. Okay, now we can see our roads, how the one house front, one house back, like that we are building, no? In that place, in this Mohenjo-daro and Harappa place, the house are straight in one line. Okay, there is no house come front, there is no house goes inside. All houses are built in one line. Okay, the roads were clearly cleaned by the winds. If wind flows, the road will get clean. Okay, like that the roads were built. Buildings are not allowed to encroach upon the public highways. Okay, that I told you, know, the buildings are not coming out of the place. There is a boundary, the buildings will not come to the road. Okay, exactly where they are have, that will the buildings were located. Okay, the main streets followed a grid pattern running from the north to south or from east to west. The houses stood on both the sides of the street. Okay, were rounded at corners to allow cars to move easily. The streets crossed one another at right angle. Okay, the street crossed at, see the next, this is the street, the next street will cross in the correct place. Okay, there is no curved or anything like that. Okay, okay, the streets crossed one another at right angle, dividing the city in the square or rectangular blocks. The houses ranged from single room to bigger houses with courtyard having up 12 rooms. Most of the houses had double stories. They were made of burnt bricks, mud mortar. Okay. Yes, every house had a bathroom, a storeroom, a kitchen, a well, and a dustbins. A kitchen had a fireplace with a oven in the courtyard. Bathrooms had a paved and slanting floor. Doors and windows open on the streets. Houses drains emptied waste water into the street drains, which led to the main drains, which emptied themselves in the outskirts of the city. Okay, this is the town planning and house planning, dwelling house. Okay, this is the place. What we read, all situated in the town, in the town and the lower part and in the street. Okay, now you learnt town planning, the citadel, the place where the nobles live, the lower part where the people who are common people live, and the roads and the houses, how the houses, like our houses only, they have everything, kitchen, bathroom, storeroom, and one room house, and a 12 room house, and a stories house, that is a one first floor, second floor houses they had. Okay, this is about the streets and the houses. Okay, that is the first one. The next thing, we come to know the drainage system of Mohenjo-daro and the great bath of Mohenjo-daro. Okay, this is the drainage system. Already we read in the town planning, and that is in the housing, they had the main drainage system. From every house the drainage will come to this main drainage system. Okay, that we are going to read. The Indus Valley people had a high sense of health and sanitation. They possessed the elaborate drainage system. Each house had its own small drains, which were directly connected with the street drain, which ran under the main streets and below many lanes. How we have nowadays, okay, same. Every house has a drainage system. We are connected under the road under the street and which goes to the main drainage system. Same thing they had 3000 years before, isn't it? That is very very important. Now we are had a great thing, yes, of course, but they had 3000 BCE before Jesus birth. 3000 years back they had this kind of system. That's why they had a well civic organization. Okay, the street which ran under the main street and below the many lanes. Each house had its own soak pit and water flowed from this sink into the underground sewers in the streets. The drains were made of mortar, lime and gypsum. Okay, then only they cannot leak. Okay, this is like a tar. How we are putting the road in tar, like that they are using this kind of things and make it grip. They were covered with the bricks and stones. They were manholes at regular intervals for inspection. How people are cleaning now also, we are using people to clean. That time itself they had people to clean that manholes, the drainage system. People did not throw any ash or other refuse in these drains. Okay, now we learnt about the drainage system. This is every house had a drainage system that comes to the main connection of the drainage. Next we'll come to know about the great bath. Okay, this is very very interesting one, like a swimming pool. Can you see the swimming pool in the middle? Yes, 7 meters width and 2.5 meters width deep. Okay, and this is like rooms. Okay, people can take bath and come and change their clothes. Okay, and this side we have fresh water flow and like the one side the dirty water will go out. And the out of the swimming pool they have the hammam. The hot air will come after taking bath. The cool air, they'll come and dry themselves. Okay, this is a beautiful place, a great bath in Mohenjo-daro. We shall we learn about that. The great bath unearthed at Mohenjo-daro, it resembles a large swimming pool. Okay, this building is 55 meters long and 35 meters wide. This is the building, 55 meters long and 35 meters wide. Okay, there is a swimming pool in the center. Can you see the swimming pool? Yes, that is in center with 12 meters long. The swimming pool is 12 meters long and 2.5 meters deep. Okay, and 7 meters wide. 12 meters long, the swimming pool is 12 meters long and 7 meters width and 2.5 meters depth deep. Okay, people can go inside and take bath. Okay, the galleries and rooms all around. Can you see the galleries and rooms all around the swimming pool? Okay, and it was used on the religious festival. It was a flight of steps at either end. It was fed by the well nearby. Arrangements had been made to discharge the dirty water by the human drain. Okay, this pool is very strong and watertight near the southwest corner of the great bath. Again, it's made up of mortar and lime gypsum. It's made up of that. That's why this it's watertight. The water will not go out of the pool. Okay, can you see this picture? Yes, again we'll see one more time. 12 meter long and 7 meter wide, the swimming pool. 2.5 meter depth of the swimming pool, and the full area is 55 meters long and 35 meters wide. Okay, now you come to know this about the great bath. Why they are using? For the religious purpose. The opposite rooms, they have rooms to change their clothes, or priest also will stay there and do some rituals things. Okay, the one side the dirty water will go, the other side the pure water will come. And they have the hammam, the air, they have the air bath. Okay, the hot air bath. They'll take the, they come out of the room and they'll take the hot air bath after coming from the cool bath. Why they are using always they come and take bath? No. People use this bath when the religious festival time. Okay, when they had their rituals or traditions or the festival time, they'll come and take bath here. Now we came to know about the drainage system and the great bath. Okay. Okay, next we learn about the granaries. Okay, where people will store the grains. Okay, and the next one is dockyard. This is the port. We are going to learn about this two structure. Okay, granaries, by the way, the word itself says people will store the grains in this place only. We are going to learn about this 45.71 long meter. Okay, this is the place, and 15.23 meter wide this place. 45.71 meter long and 15.23 meters wide. Okay, this place, we see this place, we read about this, why they are using this. Okay. Okay, this granary is found at Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Lothal and Kalibang. Okay, this is the place you should know, this Kalibang and Lothal. Okay, in this place only people found this kind of granaries. Okay, yes, the largest granary was found at Mohenjo-daro. This is the place, Mohenjo-daro. Yes, the largest granary found in Mohenjo-daro. Okay, it's measured 45.71 meters length and 15.23 meters breadth, that means wide. At Harappa, there were two rows of six granaries with wide passage between them. The granaries were used to store surplus grain. Near these granaries, circular brick platform were have been found. They were probably meant for threshing the grain. They bring the grains here, they clean and they store in these rooms. Okay, these granaries were built close to rivers so that the grains could be easily transported to the boats and through the boats to the other places. Next, we are going to learn about the dockyards. Has been discovered at Lothal. See, we find this port is in Lothal. Okay, at present it's in Gujarat. Okay, Lothal. Yes, Lothal has been discovered. This means dockyard discovered in Lothal. It was important trading and manufacturing center of this Indus Valley civilization. This dockyard made of baked bricks was connected by the channels to the Gulf of Cambay. The dockyard at Lothal was used for carrying out the overseas trade. Okay, this is the picture of the dockyard. Dockyard means, maybe it's a new word for you, this is a port. Okay, people used to do the business from here. They'll come and bring the things here, they take the things, export, import the things from this kind of a port. Okay, it's situated in the Lothal, the lower part of the Gujarat. Okay, this is the place, Lothal. Can you see Gujarat? Yes, this is Arabian Sea, the part of Gujarat. Yes, this is Lothal. They found the dockyard there, the Kalibang. They found this granaries there. Even the granaries we find in the Kalibang and Lothal also. Okay, and dockyard they find in the Lothal. Dockyard means a port. Okay, where people will do this trade. Okay, it's made up of baked bricks connected with the channels of the Gulf of Cambay. Okay, the dockyard at Lothal was used for carrying out the overseas trade. Okay, we come to know now town planning, streets of Mohenjo-daro and drainage system, great bath of Mohenjo-daro and granaries, then dockyard. You must know to write about everything as one detail answer or a short note of the these things. These things are going to be the assignment for you in your book. It's a seventh answer, I think so. That will be your detail answer. Okay, in your book. Maybe you don't have a book now at present. Maybe you can write from my teaching itself. The town plan and the perfect, they had a perfect drainage system, the great bath, and you can write about the granaries, and you can write about the dockyard. Now you are able to write town planning, the houses planning, the street planning, and that drainage system of the Mohenjo-daro, great bath, granaries, and the dockyard. You should be able to write off all these things. Okay, that is your assignment. You should write about write a note on the town planning, streets, drainage system, great bath, granaries, dockyard, and then you have to make this map, India map. Take India map and make this important things. What we said, Caliban and Lothal, okay, Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Indus River, these five rivers, Satluj, Ravi, Chenab, Jhelum, these rivers, Peshwar, Takshila, okay, this thing you can mark in this map, okay, like important. Important place you can mark in this map.